Shri T.K. Rangarajan ji.
Thank you, Vice Chairman. Finance Minister's longest speech has not created any confidence to any section of the society. I am disappointed by your budget, Madam. Nothing concrete in the budget for agriculture or unemployed or manufacturing, education, health in this budget. See, economy is going on slowdown. What is the reason? Will the government submit a white paper on that? Merely talking that, why not you submit a white paper? Why this economy is slowdown? Demonetization ruined the economy. I don't know whether you will agree to that. The government should come out with an open thing. We have committed a mistake. Demonetization has been ruined this economy. This tiny, small, medium industries, real estate, all ruined. GST, the way it was implemented, get further blow in the economy. See, you are creating a new income tax, old regime and new regime. I spoke to several office people. Nobody is happy. This old regime is better. If your new regime means they cannot invest. You don't want people to save. You want to spend money. But people mentality wanted to save for their future. So your new regime is not going to work. And people are not happy. For Manrega, you have reduced the revised estimate from 7,000 to 6,500 crore. So this is not going to help to the ordinary people, in village people. In your speech, you have said the budget to boost their income and enhance the purchasing power. I don't know how you are going to boost the common man's income. You are enhanced boost only the corporate sector. All sections of the society will suffer, especially in rural area. For the past 17 years, low in growth of investment. GDP has shrunk in every quarter in the financial year. If we want to go to 5 trillion economy, that means 14.4% GDP next 5 years. Please explain when you reply whether we can achieve 14.4% GDP. What is the way you are going to look? Data released by the Center of Monitoring Indian Economy, EMIE, shows that unemployment in India had risen to 8.3% by October 2019, the highest in the past 45 years. I request the Finance Minister, Economic Development, you have promised 2014 2 crores job will be created. 2019, you did not mention anything. You have a different agenda. Ram Temple, Kashmir, and etc. You have a different agenda. You are not able to create 2 crores. But I demand unemployment allowing 4 crores, that is 8.3%. How they behave? Where is their capacity to purchase? They are engineers. There are diploma holders, PhD, plus 2, 10th. I demand, Minister, unskilled wage for this unfortunate as unemployment allowance. I demand unemployment allowance. It may be new to you. But these unemployed people, engineers, diploma holders, teachers, they are suffering without any employment. So unemployment allowance, unskilled wage, I did not demand anything more. Let the government come, then they will get some money at least. But you have created a closure of industries. New job, no new job. The rural market has been shrunk because GST unbranded items is not able to move. Kadalimittai kulpada neenga vari podringa GST. The unemployment allowance will give some breathing for unemployed citizen. I hope this August House will support this. Let unemployed, let unemployed wait till economic development, I'm sorry, they will commit suicide. They will not wait for you. When you spoke about the agriculture, we are all worried about the Kaveri Delta district. Karnataka is thereby building new dams. Oil digging is opposed by the farmers. I don't know whether the government discussed the 16 action points with the state and agriculture association. There are some good points, I agree. Non-banking finance, they are charging about 22% interest. For an 1 acre man, for his cultivation, labor charge, if he has to pay 22% tax means, interest means, it's not possible to pay 22%. Then they ask you to give relief. In food subsidy expenditure, you have decreased 8.5%. Rural development has also increased by 1.7%. And you wanted to finish off BPCL and LIC. See, the Life Insurance Corporation of India is founded in 1956. When Parliament India passed the Life Insurance India Act, that the nationalized insurance industry India, its 245 insurance companies and provident fund societies has merged to create a state-owned Life Insurance Corporation India. As of now, 2019, Life Insurance Corporation of India had a total fund of 28.3 trillion. The total value of the sold policies in the year 2018-19, 21.4 million. Life Insurance Corporation of India settled 26 million claims 2018-19. One of the very smart 100% they do the work. It has 200 million policyholders. The entire policyholders, they don't agree with your disinvestment. The employees already has gone for 1 day strike. What do you want to, why do you want to disinvest? They are paying all your 5 year plan. I have got lot of the data with me. I can tell you, 1992-97, they have paid 56,097 crores. Every 5 year plan, LIC is paying for the government. Then why do you want a disinvestment? And you wanted to sell this BPCCL. I thought that you don't like Jawaharlal Nehru. Now only I understand you wanted to destroy all Jawaharlal Nehru creations, whether LIC or BPCL. BPCL people has gone for 2 days. Sir, I request you to reconsider. Don't disinvest LIC. And BPCL or people are already, our minister is talking with the Russian people. They had a good lunch also. That's what paper says. See, health and education is also not giving enough material. Regarding scheduled caste, the population of SC is 16.6%. Indian population, and if the budget for SC is allotted according to their population, it should be 505 lakhs crore rupee. However, the actual budget allocation is mere 83,000 crores of rupee, which is statistically short of the due term. Similarly, population of ST is 8.6. Their share in the budget allocation is only 1.76. The percentage of allocation scheduled tribe also very limited, 1.90. I request you to enhance all those things. There is already, let minister submit his opinion about the court judgment. We'll ask questions about that. The SC, ST and OBC, unless they are protected, they are given proper representation in government departments. You cannot see one chairman in any public sector of SC, ST or OBC. Still it is occupied by the other caste. So I request the finance minister, please provide unemployment allowance through this. Please enhance the MNREGA allocation. With this, some sort of thing coming up. Otherwise, the industries are closing. New industry is not coming. And you have no light. We are able not to see any light in the future. With this, I conclude.